Everyone, in this tutorial I'm going through the for statement, which is the conditional statement, and for as like as the while statement is used to execute code iteratively, which means that we have a repeating conditions, and we can explain its action in terms of the while statement too, but for has another usage. A for expression statement's form is as like as this one. This is for parentheses three different expression, and inside the clamme it's statements. And if you have only one statement, you don't need the clamme. The first expression is the beginning of the loop. The second expression, it's a limit. It's a condition that for loop is going to be done until the second expression is executed. And the third expression, it's going to give a new value of the first expression that for loop is going to run. We have a few examples, and for this one I have used an integer I. It is the for loops variable, and I is beginning from 1 until I is less than or equal to one, n. Its loop is going go through, and the last expression we have increment I with 1 to have a loop, and we are going to define a factorial value, a variable multiple equal I, which means that factorial is equal factorial multiple by I, and we are going thereafter we are going to print the factorial. I am going to use these codes in our program, and I am going to define integer I and factorial equal 1 and a value of n equal 10, and we are going to calculate the 10 factorial, and I am going to this one, it's unnecessary because it is only one statement inside for, and I am going to print f with d, it's an integer, new line, factorial. I am going to compile, I am going to run. Yes, the 10 factorial is 3,628,800, which is correct. Another example of the for loop, it is that our loop are beginning from 2. J is the loop variable, it begins from the value of 2, and k, it is a variable, defined variable. If the remainder of k divided by j is 0, then we are going to print that the value j is a divisor of value k, and we are going to increment the sum with j and put the result in sum. Okay, I am going to put those variables, those codes in our program, and I am going to define int k is equal to 50, and I am going to use int j equal. I can declare a variable inside for loop or while loop or something like that. And what is wrong in this one? I am going to show you. And I am going to use sum equals 0. I am going to compile. It's okay. Now I am going to run the program. Yes, 2 is divisor of 50, but it jumped out. And I am going to use printf. And I'm going to run again. Yes, as you see, the loop is going only one step. Why? Because that condition is, or that limit, or that condition has been reached. 50 divided by 2, the remainder is 0. And it is, the loop is running until this expression has been done. And after the first step, it is done and it is jumping out, and the sum is 0 plus 2 is 2. Okay. What we can do about this is we can use j less than or equal k, and here we are going to use an if statement. If k reminded of k divided by j is equal 0, then we are going to use those expression, and we are going to close because it is two statements. One of them is printf, one of them is summation, and after the loop we are going to write the sum. Now we are going to run, and we are going the correct. 2 is divisor of 50, 5 is divisor of 50, 10 is divisor of 50, 25 is divisor of 50, and 50 is divisor of 50. And the sum of 2, 5, 10, 25, 50 is 92. This is correct now. And are going to use another example, and we are going to define a variable, an integer c and t, which is the count is 0, and two variables double, to double variable sum is equal 0.0, and x, a usual variable. In for loop, x is the for variable, and it begins from 0.0, and the loop is going until x is less than 1, and we are going to increment x with 0.1, and we are going to use the sum of all those doubles between 0.0 and 9.9, and we are going to put all those values in sum, and we are going to print a CNT, but it is not necessary, because yes, it is okay that we can see how many times the loop has gone. And after the loop, we are going to print the sum of all those things. Now we are going to use all those codes, all those codes in our program. I'm going to make it beautiful. Okay, now I am going to compile. Everything is okay. I am going to run. As you see, the CNT has gone 11 times, and the sum of those values is 5.5, which is correct. Okay, it was all in this tutorial. See you in next tutorial.